other, it always happens. There's torches and lights, you know, we're all lights pretty much, and we're shining together, it's so much stronger. But the thing is, as you go through this reading, as you hear sermons, as you're spending time with those, I'm trying to take it seriously in the sense that you will be going back home. And you might be the one torch instead of 300. And the question is, how are you going to maintain your health? Yes, we talk about it here. And we talk about shining together. We're going to have a great time, I'm sure. This electricity outage, you know, goes on for the next few days. So it will be okay. And the hard, coolest thing is, in hard times, we grow closer to each other. So my challenge to you is this. Continue on worshiping, continue on having a great time, but also keeping back in mind, how am I going to live this year differently? And what are the things from camp can I take home with you that I can use for the rest of the year? Like I said again, shining is not enough. That's what we're calling you. That's what we're calling you. Reflect a little bit about your life. And ask God, right this moment, what are the things in my life that I have not made out of the five things that were given? Are there idols still in my life that I need to do? Are there sins in my life that are still there that I haven't managed to let go of? Or has it been difficult for you to love God due to some of the circumstances you've been going through? Maybe the issue of youth that you have in your heart is the issue of trust. Maybe some of you are graduating soon. Asking God, what am I supposed to do with my life? Maybe some of you are going through a hard time with family, wondering what do I want to